Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we're back in the Curious Expedition. So, last time we managed to complete the first expedition, which is always kind of the easier. You know, I rarely find anything easy in this game, but it's a smaller map, so the chance of finding the Golden Pyramid is a lot bigger. But this time we are gonna have to pick one of these. So we have the Deadly Arctic and we have the Opulent Desert. Let's see. I think we're gonna try the Opulent Desert. Yeah. That sounds the most appealing to me at the moment. After a good night's rest, I boarded the ship. We had a little time before the ship would be ready, so I had one last pot of tea. A military chap approached me and spoke of a deserter who had gone rogue with the natives. I would be suitably rewarded if I could bring the coward home to face justice. Okay, well, let's see if we can do that. The soldier appeared relieved as I accepted his request. He saluted me and wished us luck before leaving the harbor. I was proud to see that my fame had spread amongst adventurous spirits. Many new recruits showed up, willing to accompany my expedition into the unknown. Who did I want to recruit? We have a lot of blue stuff, and we have our donkey. Oh, they're all like blue dices, so definitely need something else. What is this? Oh, fine, Conrad. Now we have the wound treatment, which is really nice. Start each expedition with a standing bonus. Very nice. And you can make paintings. So what about you guys? Okay, cook. So you can cook some food, which I also haven't really figured out how to utilize. You're superstitious. Then we have Privateer Alexander Herold. You are a mountain guide. Okay, so green and green, what about you? You would add some combat, so that would be really, really nice. Even though you're a diplomat, then you have combat skills. That's interesting. Increases prices when bartering. Toughness 6 capacity. Huh. You're a mountain trooper. Would have thought you would have better combat skill, but you're good at defense. But we don't really have any combat skills, so I think we're gonna go with James Sterling. We would bolster the expedition team with a talent such as James Sterling. Just in time, our ship was primed for departure. Okay, let's see. What did I choose? I was was it the jungle or the desert? I already forgot. Opulent desert. I think it was a desert. Okay. But either way, this is definitely something we're gonna need. So if we buy all of these, can't buy all of these. Okay. And now we can actually heal wounds, so we won't necessarily need this. We didn't go to the Arctic, so we don't need the snowshoes. This is for the jungle, so I hope I'm right that it was a desert. Can't remember now. Anyway, climbing gear, rope, shovels, torch. Well, we have two torches, and we have some dynamite. Let's just buy all of this. Deal. My heart jumped with joy as I heard that the vessel was ready to sally forth. Set sail. Oh wow, was it a... No, it is desert. Okay. So I remember correctly. After too many salty days at sea, we finally reached the shore of our expedition area. The land lay open in front of us like an invitation to an adventure. Okay, so we can't actually sell this when we're back home, it seems. Because I didn't get the option to do that, so we might as well bring it with us and see if we can sell it. At a trader or something, but it wasn't really worth anything, was it? The last trader we were at, so... I don't know. Well, it's a desert, so we should need some water. Make sure we have a good supply of that. Okay. That should do it, I think. You sure like water? Yeah, well, especially when I'm in the desert, I especially like it. Okay, what can we do here? So, we need to go down this direction somewhere. Always had to know, so it's probably over here somewhere because of that maybe passing middle line. Okay. And we needed to find a deserter, so that is gonna be interesting. Let's just kind of head out in the middle, I think. Oh wow, look at that, that was pretty nice. Oh, look at all the water that they're drinking. Oh, and a village. Perfect. Enter village. This evening we reached a village. The natives were apparently the best scouts known to this region. Today we reached the camp of a nomadic tribe. I could tell they were performing some kind of ceremony. While the team unpacked our equipment, I observed the rites with interest. An ornate stone idol was positioned front and center of the village. The natives observed us with intrigue. They were polite and offered to help our cause. Upon our arrival, Yegenhi Taraboa began to converse with the natives. Okay, let's see, can we trade anything? Do we want this book? It doesn't have any value, so where can we use it? Very strange. We do have some whiskey, but food is always in high demand. I have to sell one of these. Can we get a little bit of food then? Oh, there's also these. Interesting adrenalizing effect. Used to refill some sanity. Value 5. Just buy a couple of mangoes. Deal. And can we recruit anyone? No. Okay, change my mind. We were at this time clearly their welcome guests. They remained very polite and wanted to talk some more. An elderly woman placed some fruit by the idol. Yeah. If we stay for the night, I'm pretty sure we're gonna get the option to steal the idol. But things have been going pretty badly lately, so I think I better not do that. So, well, let's just leave and see what happens. Oh nice, there's something right down here, so let's go down here. Let's see. Is that a cave? No, it's a tomb. Interesting. A small pyramid just barely reached out of the dunes. It must have been some kind of grave built by a long forgotten civilization. A small opening led into the darkness. Have we seen one that looks like this before? Maybe once or something? What? Haven't seen many of those. Oh, look at this. Very interesting. We stumbled into the pyramid. It seemed to be rather old and had remained untouched for a long time. There was a stone sarcophagus in the center of the small chamber. Dust filled the air as we lifted the cover from the sarcophagus. Inside we discovered a perfectly preserved mummy. All of a sudden, it started to groan and limp towards us. Yegeni Terapur let out a piercing scream and almost fainted. Oh wow! Oh, this is exciting! Huh, I haven't had this happen before. That is very cool. Huh. Very, very cool. Hey, I'm probably gonna fail completely. I can shoot. Quick jump. Nice. And this is probably some kind of defensive stuff. Look out, shield. If I move this. No, it has to be those two. And if I roll, and I put these back, then if I use this one, then I can increase my attack thing like this. So, and if I do this, no, it's only this one. Well, attack, and Oh, okay. No defense. Okay, never mind. Ouch! Ooh, look at that. That is dangerous, that thing. Okay. Good shot. And we don't have any bullets or anything, we just have the pistol. Oh, wow. Headbutt. Ooh, this is gonna be a close call, I think. No, I think we better flee. Just make us see if we can survive this. Ooh, I was a little too close for comfort, I think. So let's just get some sanity. And yeah, problem is we have some people that are hurt. Okay, what do we get if we put you? We get better value of creative paintings. Increase sanity gain when resting in villages. And you are better at bartering. Let's promote you then. And let's promote. No, we can't. We need more points, yeah. Yeah, now we don't have anyone. Yeah, he can heal, but I don't think he can heal himself. And he's the only one. Yeah. Okay, this is probably gonna go really, really bad, but okay. Let's see what's over here. There's more of that stuff. Has there been an update? I don't think there's been an update. I don't remember seeing any of those bottomless pits. Without access to medical equipment, it was nearly impossible to prevent an injury from becoming infected. Antoine Montagnier's wound was beginning to look particularly nauseating. Yeah. Okay, well, we've got a cave. We located a cave. Its opening led into darkness of unknown depths. We needed a torch in order to venture forth safely. Well, we have one. We lit a torch and descended into the darkness. We reached a cove. It seemed to be used by the natives of this region as some kind of ceremonial tomb. Within were large web bundles that seemed to hold the remains of dead bodies. That's not creepy at all. Many of the mummies were crumbling and so could not be of any intrinsic value. However, after a thorough investigation, we managed to find one that remained intact. Okay, so we're gonna steal a mummy? Okay, fame 100. Wow. Okay. We're making ourselves very unpopular, so... how can we go? There. Well, we need to drink something. And oops, I keep bringing up my desktop thing. Well, it's because it changed my it changed so that I couldn't get it to remove, so I had to change the settings for it. I don't usually have it kind of popping out and in. Examine. Oh, another tomb. Oh, what is that? Ugh, a raptor. Oh, wait, well. Oh, wow, look at all the stone. We're definitely gonna have to go that way up. How many days do we have? 90, and this would take us 19. Okay, well, let's check this out. The tip of a pyramid had been almost completely enveloped by the sand. It is likely to be a grave built by an ancient civilization. A small opening led into the darkness. Oh, that's another... Yeah, right. We entered the dark tomb. It seemed to be rather old and had remained untouched for a long time. In the center of the room lay a stone sarcophagus. Well, let's just open it because I want to see if it's the same thing. Yeah, it is the same thing. So, and all I can do is fight. So, I just wanted to see if maybe you could get something else. Let's take you and you. And see if we can go out. Oh, I would have liked to get a I would have liked to get a sword, but that was not gonna happen. Okay. There There we go. So, what is you? Chemistry. Use this one. Look out. Use this. Shot. Are we not gonna win this? We're gonna have to flee again, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Yeah. I'm gonna have to. Find one of. Okay. I guess we need to go up. I know we have like something else we need to do, but even though it could be, it's probably not all the way up there, it's probably here, so we might be able to sneak around this way. Well, let's try and hope we can outrun that raptor. Hey, some kind of a shipwreck, interesting. We found something highly unusual. We found the remains of an old boat. As far as I could tell, it must have been some kind of pirate ship. Time had certainly taken its toll on the once majestic vessel. I tried to identify the name, Rida. I was confident we would find something valuable here. I instructed the people to form small teams and investigate the surroundings. Okay, so we can blow away through the mountains. Ugh, look at this. Okay. It's not good, but if we run down here, maybe we could. But I don't know how deep this is. And I don't really want to fight that raptor, so. Ooh, this is not good. Okay. Very, very deep all of this. Okay, well, we're good for that one. Oh yeah, now stuff happens. The hacking cough sounded terrible, so I had to spend time to make sure he survived this episode. Eventually his condition improved enough so that we could continue the journey, but we did lose time. Ooh yeah. Okay. Oh yeah. Oh, ooh, look at that. An infected wound was tantamount to a death sentence in these conditions, and Antoine Montagnier had succumbed to his wounds today. Oh, that is sad. We lost someone. Okay, how? Like that, right? Yeah, nice. So now we should be able to get to this at least. Explore. Everyone rejoiced at the sight of water, a refuge of life in the midst of this desolate region. I really like this place, yeah. Okay, we're gonna rest overnight. We prepared camp and allowed everyone to rest. One soul was staring back from the abyss. Even the warming flames of the campfire did not to ease our minds. Our people were growing tense and a discussion between James Sterling, Yegani Terapora, it escalated into a heated argument. A moment later, the pair were throwing fisticuffs and trying to strangle each other with grave intentions. We're gonna arrest you. Okay, that didn't work. So, our attempt to subdue Yegani Terapora was unsuccessful. She slipped away, screaming angrily at us, and strode angrily into the wilderness. Ah, okay. Resting, resting, resting. We could have easily spent weeks resting here. I would miss the cool air by the oasis water. So let's see if we might find a pyramid over here. I haven't really had luck finding the deserter. Jim Sterling approached me with an upset look on his face. He had misplaced an old letter of his deceased father that he always kept on him. He begged me to remain in the area to search for it. I knew we could easily lose a day or two here. Well, we don't have a lot of people, so we might as well be supportive. Oh nice. Look at that. We spent a while looking for the missing object. We did not find the object, but perhaps fatefully we discovered something else. Okay, we got some ropes. Let's go over here. Oh, what is that? We were exhausted and terribly hungry as the night fell. James Sterling approached me with a suggestion. If we butchered one of our animals, we would regain much needed energy and instill new hope. I usually don't do this because I don't like doing it, but should we? We're gonna try this once. My decision was made with great reluctance. We slaughtered Sovaksha and cooked his meat over the campfire. I was speechless and felt helpless, but at least our filled stomachs brightened the mood a bit. Wow. Explore. We approached an old campsite. There were debris of what seemed to be a failed expedition from long before we had stepped foot in this land. The rotten remains of what must have been an Arabian explorer presented us with a gnarly smile. The camp reeked. Yeah, I can imagine. My instinct said we would find something of value here. I instructed the people to form small teams and investigate the surroundings. Okay, we were delighted to see that one of the corpses was still clinging to valuable equipment. Ooh, that is something that is useful. Nice. Okay, so, it looks like it wants us to go up here. Yeah, there's a hyena too. Oh, but it's moving away from us. Please, Lionty. Well, we didn't find the deserter, but that would probably have been all the way down here, so. We're gonna head home and rejoice in the fact that we made it home in one piece, and that's number first actually. The pyramid of gold was our goal, but for the claiming. After all this hardship, extraordinary pride overcame me. I knew that this name, Johan Huizinga, would not be forgotten. To a nice, great golden pyramid. Any world bonus, please? And we're number one. Yep. Hey. Finish expedition. But is that a whiskey bottle? Yep. Hey. Cult vision. Reveals the locations of all stone souls and increases the radius when analyzing them. I am a reduced move cost when crossing hills. And I survive a little longer when all alone. Let's go for this one. Though the last one would probably become relevant as usual when it's me playing. Because I tend to somehow kill off all my crew members. Okay. Wow, look at that. We are far ahead. Okay, so we are gonna give this one, and we're gonna sell this one. It's not a lot of money we have. New, very nice. Okay, that was the second expedition, so now we have the third one coming up. Dark jungle, the unseen desert, and the magnificent Arctic. Interesting. Well, you'll have to choose one in the next episode. So, thank you very much for watching, and please do leave a like and a comment, and yeah, let me know. Have you tried playing this game, and what did you think of it? I would love to hear about it. So, do take care, everyone, and happy gaming.